Hi. In this lesson, we're going to look at an overview of the traffic manager and how throttling policies are used in the API manager product. So to start off, the traffic manager is mainly powered by the very powerful Siddhi runtime, which is the same runtime that is used in our complex event processor product. And the traffic manager enables you to design very flexible throttling policies based on either request count or bandwidth. And out of the box, it will support also blocking API requests based on attributes such as the user, IP address, the application, and the API that is being used. Also, we also have the burst control feature, which prevents overuse of APIs for within small durations of time. And finally, we also allow the creation of advanced custom throttling policies based on HTTP headers and user attributes, and so on. So let's take a look at how the how throttling policies are used in the product and how they get engaged. So to begin with, the admin dashboard UI is used to actually create and define your throttling policies. And once a throttling policy is created, it will be pushed to the traffic manager via the JMS protocol, and then that particular throttling policy will get deployed on the traffic manager, and it will be ready to be engaged. So then what happens is, if a given API that is actually deployed on the API gateway receives an invocation, the API gateway will publish event to the traffic manager, notifying it that a given API has been called. So what the traffic manager then does is, it will listen to those events via the event receiver, and then execute those events against the throttling policies that have been installed at the traffic manager level. And once that happens, if a given throttling policy gets set off by the events that arrive, then the traffic manager will notify the API gateway again via a JMS topic, and then the API gateway will actually stop invocations for that particular API from actually going through. So this is the flow when it comes to the throttling policy. We also talked about the blocking condition, which is slightly different from how the throttling policies work. So the blocking condition will get directly deployed at the gateway level. So the blocking conditions operate against a particular a static attribute, such as, for example, an IP address. So they will be engaged directly on the gateway itself. So if a given API invocation comes along that actually triggers any of those blocking conditions at the gateway level itself, that particular invocation will be blocked. So let's look at the different kinds of throttling policies that are available by the API manager. So we've got application throttling policies, subscription throttling policies, which include burst controlling, API level or advanced throttling policies. Then we've got custom throttling policies, and as well as blocking conditions. So in order to understand how the these various combinations of policies will get engaged. Let's just take a look at the policy execution order. So what first happens is when a request arrives at the API gateway, the API gateway will first check if a blocking condition that has been pre-configured on that on the API gateway gets set off. If that's fine, if no blocking conditions are set off, the next thing that will happen is that the check will happen is that if there are any API level policies that should be set off against a given request. And if not, if there are no API level policies, the next check is at API resource level. So there are two levels here. So you've got the API itself, and you've got the individual resources within those APIs. So we have the option of setting the policy for the entire API or at individual resource level as well. So it will check both those. And next, the next policy that will be checked are the subscription level throttling policies. And from then on, what comes next is the application level throttling policies. And finally, you have the custom policies, if they exist or not. And finally, we have this concept of hard level throttling, which basically what that means is pretty much is that we can actually set a limit for what the backend will support. For example, if your actual backend can only support 1,000 requests per second, you will set the hard throttling limit to that value. And so what happens is if for any reason that gets triggered, if at the API manager level, it will not forward that request to your backend. So that is the order of precedence when it comes to how the throttling policies are applied. And in each instance, you have events that are published from the gateway to the traffic manager in order to engage these policies. So this concludes this lesson where we looked at the overview of the traffic manager and how throttling policies are used in the API manager product. Thank you.